Hi friends! In today's short video, I'll show you how you can use Figma's plugin API to instantly add code snippets to your variables. I know that plugin API can sound scary if you've never coded before, but I promise that it's not that bad, and all you need to get started is the Visual Studio Code Editor, which you can download for free, and also Figma's desktop app. You also don't actually need to publish any plugins, and you can just use the API to automate mundane tasks within your own files. For the demo of this short tutorial, I'll be using the Atlassian design tokens file, which you can get from their Figma community page. So once you duplicate this file and go inside the local variables, you can see hundreds and hundreds of variables here. And then when you go into individual variable setting, you can see the option for code syntax here, which currently doesn't have anything. And if we were to add them manually, it would take a long, long time, which is why we're going to create a plugin to make this much faster. So I'm going to close the variables for now, and I'm also going to create just a blank page. The first thing that we're going to do is we're going to go to Plugins, Development, and we're going to create a new plugin. This one could just be for Figma design, and I'll call it something like Code Snippets Tutorial. We're also only going to run it once. And you can save it wherever you want. Then you're going to open a new window inside Visual Studio Code. From here, I'm just going to take this folder and open it inside Visual Studio Code. So we do need to do a couple of setup things here. The first one is I'm going to install the typings. Then we also need to compile TypeScript into JavaScript. Now we can go ahead and check to see if our template plugin works. So I'm going to return to the Figma file. From here, I'm just going to go to Plugins, Development, Code Snippets Tutorial. And as you can see, I have 5 orange squares here. So this is just the default that came with the template, and you can find all the code in code.ts. So we confirm that the plugin works, and we actually don't need this code anymore. I'm going to remove it, and I'm only going to leave the Figma.close plugin. The next thing that we want to do is, first I'm going to delete this. But now we'll want to get the ID of a variable collection for which we'll be modifying the code snippets. And there are a couple of ways to do that, but the fastest way would be is to do it directly through the Figma's desktop app by using the console. So I'm going to go to Plugins, Development, Open Console. We can clear this out. From here, I'm going to do Figma.variables and get local variable collections. I only have one variable collection in this file, so I get one item here, and this is the collection ID. I'm going to copy that, and we'll return to the file, and I'm going to save it inside a variable here. So we'll do const collection, and from here we'll do figma.variables, and then get variable collection by ID. Something we can do to double check that we indeed got our collection is console log collection. And now I'm going to return to our file, clear out the console, and we're going to run last plugin. And here you can see we have output with our collection. So we'll return to Visual Studio, remove the console log. The next thing that we want to do is grab all of our variables from this collection. And while we do know that this collection with this collection ID exists, we want to add an extra safety check. So I'm going to do if collection. Then inside here, we're going to create a variable for all Figma variables. And it's going to be collection. So this variable here. And we're going to grab variable IDs. Once again, what we can do is we can console log all variables just to confirm that this indeed works. You can do command option P keyboard shortcut to run the last plugin. So here in the console, you can see I have a list, an array of a bunch of variable IDs. Now we'll remove this console log. And what I want to do instead, I want to run a function that assigns code snippets to my variables. I'm going to do assign code snippets. And we'll do it on all variables. It's currently giving me an error because the function does not exist yet. We can create this function and it's going to be all variables. We need to give this a type, and it's going to be an array of strings. What we'll do here is that we'll iterate through each variable inside this array, and we'll assign it a code snippet. So for each variable inside this list, first we're going to grab that variable. And then we're going to create a variable for code snippet. And for now, we can just do something like, hello, I'm a code snippet, just for test. And then for this variable, we're going to set the code syntax. So variable, set variable code syntax. And there are two arguments that we need to pass. The first one is for which platform, and we'll just do web. And then we'll do code snippet. Now we'll return to our file and run the last plugin. And now we're just going to check to see that indeed we now have a code syntax. It's for the web platform. And it just says, hello, I'm a code snippet. Now that we know that this works, we can go ahead and update this code snippet to give us something more substantial. First, what I'm going to do is let's remove this. And let's just start by assigning it a variable name. We'll do variable.name. And it's getting mad at me because the variable itself may not exist, like if a variable ID happens to not exist. So we're going to just add a question mark here. And then now it says that if the variable does not exist, the code snippet may not exist. So something that we can do is we can check if a code snippet exists, then we add the code snippet, but if it doesn't, we'll just say something like no snippet. Let's return to Figma, and we're going to run the plugin again. Now when I go to the variable under the web platform, we have the variable name instead. And so in general, what these code snippets mean is that if, let's say, I have a rectangle and let's give it some background color, when we go inside the dev mode, we get our own modified code value instead of something like a hex value. But obviously in the real world, the code variable name is probably not going to be useful to us. So what we can do is convert this name to match plain CSS variables. To do that, we're going to return to our code editor. And what I'm going to do here is I'll format it to look like a CSS variable. So I'll add var dashes, and then we'll do variable name, and then we'll close. And now when we return and run the plugin, you can see that now it shows var and then color text default. One thing is here we want to have dashes instead. So what I'm going to do is return to the code editor. And what we're going to do is replace all instances of the front slashes with the dashes. So this first argument looks for all the front slashes, and the second argument just says, here's what you should replace this with. So let's save, return, run the plugin, and now my code snippet has been updated to have the dashes. When we return to the dev mode, you can see that we now have the correct variable name here. And of course, needless to say, is that all of your variables are updated, which is just a huge time saver if you have tons and tons of variables. And of course, we did the plain CSS variable syntax here. But if, let's say, you're using style components and you have some custom function that grabs variable names, you can, of course, just modify the code snippet function and use that instead. And of course, you can do the same thing for other platforms like iOS or Android. So this is it. I hope this was useful. I'll link everything below. Please let me know if you have any questions. And until next time, bye-bye.